ओके मैम।
So today we are going to discuss about that new topic and a very small topic, three topics we combine and discussing now: task, process, and threats. Okay. So what is task, process, and threats? What is the relation between these three, and what are the responsibilities of this kernel regarding this task, process, and what is process management? Handle about this. I mean, what are the services handled regarding this process, and what is the life cycle of this process, and how to schedule the task, how to synchronize the task, and other things we are going to discuss today. First of all, tell me the general meaning of the task, students. What is the general meaning of the task? This some work, something work. I mean, something some work to be done. Yes or no? Yes or no, ma? So the term task refers to something to be done, and in the operating system context, it can also called as a job. Okay? Task can also be called as a job in the operating system context. And in the operating system, these tasks can be defined as the program and the execution, current program and the execution, and the related information maintained by the operating system for the program. Okay, so here how the task is defined in the operating system context means it is defined as the program in execution and the related information maintained by the operating system for the program for the proper execution of the program. And this task is also known as job in operating system context. A program or a part of it in execution is called as a process. That is the definition of the process. And the term task, job, and the process are referred as the same entity under the operating system context. Okay, where it is mentioned as a job, or it is mentioned as a task, or it is mentioned as a process, everything is same entity. And now come to the process. A process is a program or a part of it in the execution. And process is also known as the instance. A process is a program or a part of it in the execution. A process is also known as the instance of a program in execution. And multiple instances of same program can execute simultaneously, whereas in the case of multi-processing system or multi-tasking system, multi-tasking system or multi-processing system, multiple number of processor are can able to execute. I mean, concurrent execution is possible in the case of multi-tasking or multi-processing system. A process that requires various system resources, like system resources, we can say CPU is one of the system resources. Why it is required for the execution of the processes or tasks, or frankly speaking, it is a program or a set of instructions, right? And memory for storing the code corresponding to the process are associated variables regarding the process, right? So memory is also required. It is also one of the system resources, and input-output devices for the information exchange. No. So these are all the various system resources like CPU, memory, I/O devices for executing the process, or for storing the code memory or corresponding code or source code, or for the associated variables along with the code, and input output devices for the information exchange. These are all required, and it is a, and the execution, the process of execution is a sequential in the case of process. Good. Next is structure of process. The concept of process that leads to the concurrent execution of the task and thereby efficient utilization of the CPU and other system resources, right? So here we are discussing the structure of this process, and concurrent execution can be achieved with the sharing of the CPU among the process. In the multi-processing system or multi-tasking system, when multiple processor under the concurrent execution is going on, and if it requires the same resources or it requires the addition of the CPU, and sharing of the CPU addition or sharing of this system resources should be achieved. I mean, concurrent execution should be achieved among the process. Process mimics a processor in properties. Some of the properties of the processor are similar to the properties of the process, like it holds a set of registers similar to the processor, and process status of the process, and a program counter. What do you mean of this program counter? What do you mean of program counter? Did you come across program counter?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what do you mean of program counter?
Instruction queue, ma'am.
Not, but program counter, it is a register, we can say, which points the address of the next instruction to be executed. Right. For example, the processor CPU is executing the first instruction. What program counter points to? It points to the address of the second instruction.
Next to two.
Okay. So a stack also is required. I mean, some of the properties of the process are similar to the properties of the processor. First one is the holding of set of register. Next is the process status and program counter. Stack for hold. What is the use of stack for temporarily holding the local variables associated with that for executing program, and code corresponding to the that source code corresponding. These are all these properties which are similar to the processor. These properties of the process is similar to the processor properties. Okay. Here you can see. This set of the registers, status register, which tells the process status, because it is having the several stages, right? It may be in the creating state, or it may be in the executing state, or it may be in the wait state, or block state, or completion, or termination state. Okay, so it detects and there is the status, current execution, current status of that. So stack pointer, working register, status register, and program counter are already, we discussed that, it points to the address of the next instruction in the memory. Next up. Here, the memory, it is having three memory categories. The process has three memory regions actually. Stack memory region, data memory region, code memory region, and what all these regions hold means, no? So the content of these memory regions are: the stack memory holds all the temporary data such as variables, such as local variables which are in this process, and data memory holds the global data for the execution of the process, and code memory contains the source code or the program code corresponding to the process. So the entire memory utilized by this execution of the process is divided into three memory regions: stack memory region, data memory region, code memory region. Stack memory holds the temporary data such as local variables which are required for the proper execution of the process. Data memory holds all the global variables which are required for the proper execution of the process. And code memory contains the source code regarding that process. And here we are discussing some of the states, different various states of the process, and transition from one state to another state. It can be clearly understood by explaining this diagram. You can see here what is the first state. It is, this diagram is called as the life cycle of the process. Life cycle of the process. In this life cycle of the process, it is having several states, like a created state. Created state means it is not known by the process. Processor, right? It is not it is not identified by the operating system. It is in the creation state. After this is created, and once it is incepted into the memory, then only it can be able to recognize by the operating system, right? And initial state of the process is called as create state, and after it is created, it will be inserted into the memory, loaded into the memory. I mean, memory allocation is possible. After that, it is placed in the queue. Okay, now so if it is once it is interpreted to the memory and placed in the queue, that means that it is ready for the execution. It is awaiting the process for execution, right? And after once the execution is started, the process is in the running state. It means the process is in running state while it is executing. While in the running state, if there is any interrupt occurred, either externally or internal interrupt occurred, so or any insufficient memory or any errors, unexpected errors or certain failures occurred, it will enter into the block state. Okay. So after that is repaired, no, after that is clear, it will again move back to the ready state, and again in the queue, again come back to the execution will be resumed. Okay. So after the execution is completed, it will move into the completed state. So these are all the five different states of the process. Okay. What is the first state of the process? Creation, create state. Once it is created, it will be inserted into the memory and identified with operating system and wait for the process with execution, and it is in ready. Okay, ready and ready for the execution. For the process, the queue it will be placed. Okay, once it is in the queue and ready for the process, we can say the process is ready state. And after the execution, once the execution started, no, it is the running state. And if during the execution, if there is any errors occurred or any interruption occurred, sudden unexpected failures occurred, it will enter into the block state. And after that, if it is cleared once and it is handled, then come back to the ready state. And after resume, the execution is resumed and then come back to the running state. After the execution is completed, no, the process will enter into the completed state. Okay, so these are all the different states of the process. So here you can see creation of the process to its termination is not a single step as we discussed now. The process traverses through a series of states during its transition from one state to another state, that is from create state to terminated state or completed state. The cycle through which the process changes state from newly created to execution completed is this cycle is called as process life cycle. Okay, so process life cycle is nothing but transition from one state to another state, from the create state to the terminated state or completed state. So process will be changed from one state to another state, and this cycle is called as process life cycle. Next is the process management. So process management of the operating system that deals with the, you can see here, creation of the process first it deals with, and after that setting of the memory space for the process. If it is a real-time operating system, block-wise the memory is allocated, and if it is general purpose operating system, actually dynamic memory allocation is possible, right? So setting up the memory space means allocating the memory space for the process, and loading the process code into the memory space means a flash memory. Usually the flash memory will enter the source code into the flash memory, and allocating the system resources for the proper execution of the process, and setting up the process control block. So similar to the task control block, each process is having its own process control block, and it is maintained the entire information regarding the process, like process or ID, that is the identifier number given for the each process. Now that is unique one, like task ID, no, process ID, and what is the current state of the process, whether the process is in the create state, execution state, block state or ready state, in which state it is. Okay. And that PCB, the content of the PCB need to be updated or modified, right? And a context pointer. Okay, so while the process is executing the process, they need to move from one context to another part of the program. The last instruction need to be the context need to be saved, right? The context saving pointer, everything, the content related to the process are saved, are stored in the process control block, and setting up the process control block is handled by the process management. It's one of the topics. And termination of the process after the execution of the process. So these are all the things which are handled by the handled by the kernel of this operating system. So process management is one of the basic function of the kernel, and that deals with the creation of the process, setting up the memory space for the process, loading the process code into the memory space, allocating the system resources, and setting up the process control block and termination of the process. These are all the basic functionalities that are handled by the deals with the process management. And next is the third topic, that is threads. So this thread is a primitive that can execute code. Okay, an application may have multiple tasks, no? And one task may have multiple processes, right? And one process may have multiple threads. Yeah. So a thread is a single sequential flow of control within a process. Okay, a thread is also known as a lightweight process. We can also call this thread as lightweight process. A process can have many threads for execution. One process may have multiple threads. Okay, so these students today, we discussed about that task, process, threads, and relation between these task, process, and the basic definitions of this task, process, threads, and what are the basic functionalities of the kernel of the operating system regarding this task, process, and threads. If you have any doubts, please ask me, ma'am.